We all like to hear stories on our past, how people and societies were different more or less long ago. But studying and narrating the past is more than storytelling. Even if ancient times are often put behind us, they definitely help to look far ahead. For this reason, I have always been fascinated by time machines as a means to learn on our past, but also as a way to see our future. I am a biologist and passionate about the evolution of species and the evolution of mankind. I spend my days looking at bones and teeth of ancient fossils from the Cradle of Humankind in South Africa. When I was a teenager, I was dreaming of the sites of Kromdraai and Sterfontein in the Cradle of Humankind not far from Johannesburg. I wanted not only to travel from La France to South Africa, but I also wanted to travel in time. I wanted to see the Cradle of Humankind a few million years ago. I felt that everything constantly changes, our bodies and minds, and therefore our societies, which evolved in exactly the same way as other animals did. In this talk, I will support this claim using a broad range of examples taken from a variety of approaches falling under the umbrella term paleosciences. Using these approaches, the exploration of the past reveals us the foundation of life since its beginning, but also reveals our future. Many human and animal societies disappeared in the past, but others survived and faced important challenges. In past human societies, for instance, lack of resources often led to political instability like wars or revolutions. For instance, the past civilizations of Great Zimbabwe in Southern Africa or Easter Island in the Pacific and many others were powerful, but at some stage they left massive monuments and ruins behind. These societies failed because they overused their natural resources. And these examples can easily be generalized. The past tells us that the misuse of resources in most animal societies finally leads to disorganization such as social instability. Now, let's have a look at past and today's species rather than societies. Many of them disappeared following exactly the same scenario as human societies did. For instance, the dodo was a flightless bird living in the island of Mauritius. It is a symbol of species extinction, an example among hundreds of others equally remarkable. This species got extinct very rapidly after its resources have been destroyed. Modern approaches in paleosciences are extremely useful to travel in time. We can learn from our past and present in order to build a time machine and to predict our future. Because species and societies are very much like engineering systems, I mean inventions produced by time. If we can dissect out such systems, we can unravel trends to predict future changes. To run my time machine, I became an evolutionary biologist, a paleontologist and archaeologist. By working in the Cradle of Humankind, I focused my research on one main central question. How did we become human? How our human bodies and minds, how our engineering systems became so unique? As a paleontologist, I study fossils from the Cradle of Humankind to unravel the most recent inventions of nature that made us uniquely humans. The way we slowly grow our disproportionate brains is one of these inventions. It is absolutely unique in the animal kingdom. This unique growth of a large brain was clearly associated with the capacity of our ancestors to use much more energy than any other species of our size. This invention gave our ancestors the capacity to rapidly adapt their societies to sudden changes. As an evolutionary ecologist, I investigate the differences between living species as the end product of distinct stories. Species are engineering systems, just fantastic time machines. Investigating how species used their resources is a very powerful way to understand how they evolved. This way, I investigate the power engineering of life. For instance, how the human disproportionate brain grows, how much resources it consumes throughout lifetime. As an archaeologist, I investigate the traces of behaviors left behind by past societies. I track signs of cooperation, competition, lifestyles. I also learn how behaviors and societies changed in relation to adaptations of bodies, how bodies and behaviors were in a twin during evolution. Let me give you just one final example that beautifully illustrates the inner twinning between the evolution of bodies and minds. Only about 1/3 of adult humans can digest the natural milk sugar because they have one mutation in their genome. Paleosciences tell us that this mutation originated in societies where regular milk consumption was dominant. This behavior drove a genetic change which gave the ability to digest milk to some of us only. Here are two grand lessons from paleosciences. First, how bodies change because of behavioral changes. Second, this scenario occurred at least 5 independent times in 3 different places. On a nearly daily basis, paleosciences tell us that the same causes often produced the same effects in the past in an incredible variety of societies. Using paleosciences, we learn the engineering process of life and we foresee the probable consequences of our behaviors. What are the 3 main lessons taken from paleosciences? First, human societies have always been using limited resources. The sun and the air are of course technically unlimited, but we don't eat or drink them. Second, our survival or death will depend exclusively on our capacity to properly use resources and to manage our environments. When working in the cradle of humankind and discovering many extinct species, you realize how this claim is universal. Third, paleosciences far exceed the scientific field, I mean the study of pure mechanisms, as if our bodies were only machines. Failure or success will depend on collective behaviors, because the increase of inequalities systematically leads to failure. It is just a matter of time. Learning from paleosciences is a survival issue for humanity. Many times, other species have already seen the end of their story. The time machine is talking to us, and we should listen.